16th talked about how these insane dreamers are trying to promulgate this universal republic or this universal democracy.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's what this new city is, okay? And so it's this Judeo-Masonic plot against not only the church, but the state. We see it coming to a head, and we're not that far off from serious events in conjunction with the consensus of Catholic prophecy that Christopher and I study pretty readily. But so, again, it's backwards thinking, and according to, again, Father Martin, who read The Real Third Secret, certainly we should not have any fear, okay? We should be going into this period, so to speak, this great storm altogether, of course, in prayer. We should be praying the rosary unceasingly. We should have our scapulars on. We should be doing vast penances. We should be making reparation to the Sacred Heart through the Immaculate Heart, truly doing the opposite of loving ourselves and truly giving true charity, keeping Christ focused through Our Lady, because it's going to be through Our Lady's protection that we get through this great storm. And I know I'll cover this in my book, and I know you talked about earlier how the Ark represented the church. Well, it also represents Our Lady. Okay, so through her Immaculate Heart, we're going to be protected. We're going to be hidden, okay, away from the dangers that lie ahead of us. And so we must enter the Ark of her heart and it's serious times, Christopher. I don't believe the majority really realize how close we are to serious events. And so if you're out there and you're not Catholic, it's now time to really settle your life down and come back to
enter the Ark.
Come back into the Ark.
Enter exactly. The Ark of the Church. That's essentially what I would say. You know, these broadcasts, these videos that we're putting together is to do the best that we can as laymen. I mean, Eric and I are both laymen. We will put bios up about each of us in the video towards the end of this of this episode and each episode, just to make it very clear. But it's really a matter of trying to help as many people as we can to really see, to put it all together. Because there's so many voices out there, so many confusing voices, contradictory voices, and if you don't have the true faith, if you don't have a true understanding of the faith, if you don't have the warnings from the popes, the popes prior to Vatican II were all warning about this constantly. Eric, you mentioned Freemasonry, and some people don't even know what that is, or they might see some of the signs on the road. They might think it's a friendly thing, but ever since quote unquote the Masonic Lodge was created in 1717, but we have the first warning against Freemasonry, condemning Freemasonry in 1738 by Clement XII. Then we have a succession of popes constantly warning about this sect, about this diabolic sect. Now, one must-read encyclical, and this is by Pope Leo XIII. It's called Humanum Genus. It's on Freemasonry. That's the English name of it, on Freemasonry. And, as I mentioned before about the two kingdoms that St. Augustine wrote about, the city of God, the city of man, well, in that encyclical, Leo XIII mentions that in the second paragraph, and he explains that at every point of time, at every period of time, each of these cities, the city of God and the city of man, have been in conflict with the other, and he goes into details that there's different types of weapons in warfare, but he says at this period, the partisans of evil are combining together against the church. And he said, he names this as the association called the Freemasons. He says they're no longer making it a secret. They're coming out in the open against God himself. But that is what we're seeing today, even more dramatically, because we just had Paris pass a gay marriage law. You know, this is a complete affront to the natural order, to divine law, to natural law. It's an affront to God, and I mean that's just one part of it. But this is a serious. Sure.
Sure. So everyone understands who doesn't really understand the situation. The end game or the end goal, okay, in this new world order is however you want to this universal republic, so to speak, okay, is going to be this pseudo equality and socialism, just as Pope St. Pius X warned that through the Cilion movement, socialism was coming through its tracks. Okay, so we already see this. I mean, you can see this in the laws being passed, both. Here in America and abroad over in Europe, okay, but this is a worldwide movement, okay, and apostasy against not only the Catholic Church, but against the state, okay, because they want to form a one world universal republic. And so it's I don't think your everyday non-Catholic truly understands that, and partly what Freemasonry wants to do, you know, in this Judeo-Masonic plot is of course to despoil the church of her property, but also people. You know, that's one of the aspects of communism, which most people do not realize, again, as a Judeo, part of the Judeo-Masonic plot. Okay, so we can look for that here, even in America. I mean, we're seeing all of our rights being taken away, and we're slowly, well, not at this point, it's not really slow anymore. Things are happening more readily. But we're seeing all of these laws that are passing to where the ultimate goal is to create anarchy and revolution in these various countries, both here in America and abroad. Okay, and they will introduce themselves as just as they say, out of order. Okay, and they're going to introduce themselves as the answer, so to speak. And this will be the answer. This one world. Political, economic, social system. And again, this ties in with the church because literally through Vatican II, this is what the conciliar pontiffs are teaching, okay, in terms of, you know, the naturalism, the socialism. And so, we're not that far off. And again, this is a worldwide process and movement, and of course we know, so everyone can understand, that through Our Lady and her Immaculate Heart, that we at least for a short, brief period, will be able to fight off and resist this in accordance with various great chastisements which will occur. We will at least be able to delay the reign of the Antichrist, and that's not Eric's opinion. That comes from tradition. That comes from the early fathers who teach that before the reign of the Antichrist comes about again, that Holy Christendom would be restored. And again, I will try to find those quotes. We can get those on the screen there for you, so you don't think that I'm making this. This is the opinion, but and I'm paraphrasing. I forget where it is, Christopher, in the Gospel, but it's a scripture that the Protestants misuse because it's that it's the Holy Spirit that is delaying the Antichrist. Well, the Church has. The Church has interpreted that actually as the revival of Holy Christendom. And we know this to be the period that we're going to enter where, through the Immaculate Heart, we'll be protected, but then all Catholic monarchies will be restored, and there'll be a figure called the Great Monarch that will arrive in Europe. And we'll get into that in another time, but just so you can kind of get a more overall sense how this ties into Freemasonry. So we have Freemasonry versus Catholicism, and Masonry uses your various other different sects put together in this fight against the Church is essentially what we were getting at, and which ties in with my second quote here, Christopher, from Blessed Anne Emmerich, in which she states, quote, "I saw a strange church being built up against every rule. No angels were accompanying it. In that church, nothing came from above. There was only division and chaos. It was probably a church of human creation, following the latest fashions as well as the new heterodox Church of Rome, which seems of the same kind." Again, we see the key words, human church, okay, everything on the natural level, Freemasonry.
Right. Yeah.
She goes on to continue, and you can interject, but in this strange church, all work was being mechanical. It was done according to set rules and formulae. Everything was done according to human reason. And this is where I spoke about my latest newsletter. Okay, according to these backwards thinkers, okay, modernists included, they always used this term reason. And in conjunction or contradicting tradition, we can see that this is not right reason or human reason. It's literally illogical. So they use the term reason, but it's not reason at all. And essentially, through Vatican II, everything is being reduced, okay, just down to the natural level and just down to the reason level, because there's a famous quote by Paulus Thix where he states essentially that in the end, reason will win out, okay? And knowing where we're heading, it's basically implying that the supernatural level will not be there anymore, because we have, since Vatican II, we have a